Welcome back to Strictly Politics. It's social media night on the show. I hope you've been taking note of the Twitter names of all these government officials. It would be good to follow them, keep tabs on them, engage them, and keep them honest that way. There are many, many of them in the House of Representatives, but only a few of them are active and actually engage other people on Twitter. And then there are those who are on Twitter but rarely or never tweet. Meron nga ang iba dito. Quite a number of government agencies have taken to Twitter also, but very few of them are successful. There's a long list. One such example is MMDA. One person described MMDA in a tweet, or MMDA's Twitter account in a tweet, as a motorist, and we quote, a motorist's best friend. But another government agency that needs to prove itself still and prove if it can be the college student's best friend is the Commission on Higher Education, or CHED. Dear CHED. Of course, just don't expect any announcement of suspension of college classes from them. But before we go further, joining us now on the line is MMDA spokesperson Tina Velasco. Good evening, ma'am. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, Tia. Good evening. Good evening to everybody.
Let's talk about how MMDA is using social media, ma'am. How did the MMDA decide to get on Twitter and why?
Okay. It's really a matter of Yves Gonzalez coming into joining MMDA together with Chairman Francis Valentino. He's an apps expert, an iPad developer. He's a lawyer by profession. And now that he's already the traffic czar, he's really trying to reach out to as regards the traffic situation of Metro Manila as well as the flood situation of Metro Manila. So since he's a user himself, he thought that this is the best way to efficiently reach out to the public, especially the younger population, who's basically like hooked to their phones or hooked to their computers.
Can we say that?
And they are very much the more vocal market as far as traffic is concerned. So it's pretty much a more efficient way to get in or respond to them very, very quickly in a split second, be able to answer as many of the questions that come our way. So we do have like 123,000 followers as we speak now.
Yeah, how many followers?
We have 123,000 growing.
Okay, and growing. And well, you mentioned Yves, no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
He was very famous during the elections, no, as Pico's machine. And
that's right.
Yeah. And well, that's good that you have him there, and then you have him taking care of your Twitter. Earlier, I said that, and I was quoting someone who had tweeted, "MMDA Twitter account though is a motorist's best friend."
That's right, Pia. We are trying to, in as much as we can, solve traffic overnight. We at our very best would like to reach out to as many so that they could make well-informed decisions on an everyday basis in managing their lives, facing the traffic situation of Metro Manila. And if we cannot solve traffic on the spot, we could at the very least give public advisories on a proactive basis. And it doesn't necessarily confine to just traffic, even like mall sales and warnings of special events and flood situations, and pag-asa weather reports also, we come into the picture just to make ourselves reach out to as many. So this is one way of really doing it, and we also have our Facebook account with 11,200 followers where we take their comments seriously. We may not be able to respond immediately as opposed to Twitter, but at least we put them on record and try to respond to their concerns as well. So we say we cannot wait for radio or media to help us all the time, in as much as they've been very, very helpful too. But we are saying that it's also best to go straight to our target market. And we see that many people appreciate that despite the traffic situation. So we're saying this is not the only solution, but we are also trying to manage it and manage to avoid these tweets as well, so that they can also partly help in the traffic situation. Like if these are like private car owners, mm-hmm. they can make, they're empowered to do the reroutings themselves because they're not using the public transport. And they are in a way helping Metro Manila solve traffic. So we appreciate that as well.
Yeah. Your presence on Twitter actually helped medyo deflect siguro, or I don't have the right word right now, no? Para bang medyo hindi na masyadong nagagalit yung tao sa MMDA, no? Because you're very accessible.
Galit pa rin, Pia.
Galit pa rin, paminsan-minsan.
Trying, as much as possible, gusto natin unahan lang talaga ang ating mga mananakay, tsaka commuters, at tsaka mga drivers, no? So, gusto lang namin maunahan, if we can, para sabihin naman po na hindi po tayo nagkulang, but hindi pa rin nawawala yung galit sa amin. That's something that we take for breakfast after dinner every day and down to even midnight.
Galit, pero 120,000 followers. But anyway, what advice would you give to other government agencies who are on Twitter, especially those who have just joined Twitter, like, I don't know, for example, CHED?
Okay, and I'm not in a position to advise government agencies, but we're saying that, if you make it
interesting... Kayo yung success story, eh.
I think the intergovernment cooperation, or like if our linkages to other government agencies, it will help. We can also spread the word by having the more, we have the economies of scale on followers, but if we can link ourselves to CHED or to others, maybe we can help and try to create affiliation eventually for them to start following the tweets of these other government agencies. Now, I think traffic is very relevant to the everyday commuters and drivers of Metro Manila. That's why we're probably closer to everybody. Mm-hmm. And even with the no clashes, kami pa rin po yun, because it also impacts on traffic. So I think it touches the lives of people. That's why they're compelled to follow, not necessarily as admirers, but hopefully as a useful tool. For as long as we keep ourselves proactive, then the followers keep on growing. We have also elevated ourselves to a higher level on the traffic navigation. It's something that we're already elevating ourselves beyond Twitter. Like, we can actually see our traffic in a map using this creative application. So again, EADS and a media network is able to do a tie-up to make this even more interesting. So I guess that the key there is to make it as interesting and as helpful and as responsive as possible, and for us to take accountability to it and then be attuned to the needs of our market. So that's essentially what we're trying to do, and we're trying to very hard do on a 24/7 basis.
Okay. Thank you very much, Tina Velasco of MMDA. Maraming salamat.
Maraming salamat rin po. Good night.
We have tweets in the executive and the legislative, but no one from the judiciary, at least not that I know. Sign, that would be very nice. Imagine reading the thoughts of the justices, of the Supreme Court justices. There he is. Wait, before you talk, I was going to introduce our social media analysts right now. Joining us tonight are Tonyo Cruz, I_M_Holo in mask. And Gang Badoy. Wait, sino yung judge?
I thought there was a princess. Ongkeko. She's a judge from San Pablo, Laguna.
What does she tweet? What she's going to decide?
No, actually, she was up for ombudsman. So she was tweeting the day before, like, pray for me, I'm up for something tomorrow. So, it's really interesting.
Okay.
The Supreme Court used to have a Twitter account.
They have took it down.
No explanation. Yeah, they had a huge press conference announcing it.
And then biglang
silently killed.
Ouch.
Uso naman yun sa Philippines eh.
There are many lawyers on Twitter.
Yeah, well, but...
Because we have a constituency.
Uso naman sa Philippines yung nagdi-disappear lang.
Don't you wonder what Chief Justice Corona would be saying, or even Mariano del Castillo?
Can you imagine?
I'm not... never mind.
In court now, hassle.
Anyway, let's begin with a general question muna, Tonyo, Gang, and Holo. How is politics affected by social media? Tonyo.
You want to start?
Well, we see more participation. The public tries to participate more actively in politics.
Mm-hmm. And that's a good thing, right?
It's a good thing. Yeah. It's some sort of democracy in action. But social media is not just about putting political ideas on Twitter or on Facebook. There are three legs. Social media has three legs. Mm-hmm. Content, conversation, and community.
Okay.
So if the three ingredients are there, mm-hmm. social media is a real thing.
Okay, define each of the three. Content, conversation.
Well, content, maybe pieces of information. Mm-hmm. And then community, a community of users. Mm-hmm. And then conversation, people talking about content in their community. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So if those three legs are present, there could be substantive democracy because citizens ask questions, and then the rulers or the people in government would be made to answer.
And they wave with their scepters. Yeah. They tweet with their scepters.
They tweet with their scepters. Rulers. And they have no choice but to engage, diba?
Well, there are agencies that have Twitter accounts, but it's all one way. You just post updates. So much unlike, for example, DOST Pag-asa. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Quite interactive.
Nag-joke pa yun.
Listen, they posted a few days ago a weather update about Cavite City.
Oh,
Cavite.
Okay.
I think it was a spell check error. And then they apologized. And then they would advise you magdala ng payong. So, okay. An MMDA is a gold standard in government social media.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's interactive, they fulfill a public need.
Yeah.
The problem is.
Yeah, and if you tweet them, they'll
respond in a few minutes.
I guess, and sobrang focus din naman kasi ng needs ng mga tao when they ask MMDA stuff. So I guess it gives them an advantage to be the most interactive agency. It's really real-time needs, like traffic ba from southbound, ganyan. Yeah. So it's very different from other agencies where they'll probably be asked more pressing questions that would require more voluminous answers. Mm-hmm. So MMDA, yes, definitely the gold standard. But for me, the effect of social media on politics, it's like there's a million set of new eyes watching them, so I think that's very good.
Yeah.
And the other way, it's also a fantastic chance if people are watching right now and they want to run for office, it's a fantastic chance to get votes. Mm-hmm. Because the number one thing I think that voters look for from their politicians is that we have access to them.
Right.
Minsan mag-reply sa'yo yung congressman, "Oy, isipin mo kagad, may access ako sa kanya, I like him. He listens to me, he replies, and I can tell him whatever I'm thinking." And I think that's the number one thing we look for. So it could be pro or con for both sides. Mm-hmm. For both sides, kawawa yung government institution kapag yung volume na nagtatanong sa kanya, hindi niya ma-respondan. Pero ang laki rin ng advantage for them. Mm-hmm. It's a chance to be clear. They don't rely on linear, traditional
media
venues for press cons, etc. Ito, almost immediately, they can clarify
things. Kanina, we were talking to Dinky Soliman, and she was saying that she's able to explain CCT.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because of her Twitter account, Follow.
Well, first, because for those who do not follow me on Twitter, I'm wearing this mask because I mock politicians on news break, and so therefore for fear of reprisal. But joke. But also, it's also the International Day of the Disappeared, so in solidarity with them. The point is for politicians, their behavior on social media is so raw. Mm-hmm. They expose themselves.
Yeah.
Like, for instance, I have a Twitter show. Mm-hmm. It's called TweetCon PH in partnership with Newsbreak and also with Move.ph on Facebook soon. It's a citizen journalism platform. Mm-hmm. What happens on the show, on the discussion is we invite politicians, we invite NGO workers, activists and other analysts. Mm-hmm. And then they exchange ideas. So it's a dialogue. It's a round table, round Twitter discussion.
Has an official ever said no to your invitation?
So far, none. Mitos magsaysay.
But
she had a previous engagement. But the fight between Senator Hunasdan and Jim Paredes happened on the
tweet.
On the show.
Yeah. Oh.
So I have a show too. That's right. Yeah. So I told my barrager, "Excuse me, this is my show."
Ganon.
I really. Okay, love. It's just amazing to guest with someone I can't see your face.
Yeah.
But
we know what his face is. You were like,
So it's a platform for engagement. Mm-hmm. Second, you can hold them accountable, actually.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people people would like to express their opinions, and also they would like to demand.
Yeah.
So it's a channel.
But how can you hold someone accountable if they refuse to engage?
Yes, that's a problem. Oh. In most countries where social media is quite strong, there are social media policies and guidelines adopted by government. So government officials or agencies would be required to respond.
Yeah.
Dito sa atin, kagandahang loob. Kagandahang loob ng mga politiko at ng mga opisyal. There's no policy governing
that obliges
social media use. Mm-hmm. Malacanang has long promised to release guidelines. There's no draft yet.
What office in Malacanang? Who would take care of that?
That's
PCO. Probably sila Ricky. Siguro.
Ricky,
Sorry, okay. There's a big long title, but I'm not sure. Yeah. PC who?
PC,
yeah, PC something something.
Yeah.
So long.
Well, I think that one, we created something like Dear Noy Noy before, right when he won for president.
Yeah.
One of the biggest dangers of that, from their side, would say, what if we can't reply to all the letters?
Parang maybe and what if they don't want to reply?
That's an option too, of course. If you open a channel like that, what a risk if we don't reply. But I think for us end users, meaning me, ako na nagsusulat sa mayor, I also have to have an attitude that says, I understand if we can't reply to every single letter, mm-hmm. or every single tweet. It has always been this way, diba? It's always the option of the person in power, the ruler, with his scepter, to reply or not. Yeah. And if they do, then it's a plus for them. Then they're given, they give the regular citizen access to them, and it gives them a wonderful name or a vibe with the voters and etc. So it works both ways. Like, na experience ko to sa isang, pwede ko bang hindi iname? There's one agency.
Hindi pwede.
Hala.
Sige na.
There's one agency I forget.
No.
I forgot what it was. I did suggest a letter, a website to accept letters, and the head of the agency said, ayoko kasi baka hindi ko ma-respond and lahat magagalit lang sila.
Mm-hmm.
And my reply...
And they're not on Twitter now? Or they just
joined?
I'm
not sure. And my reply was, but that's the risk we take. I mean, but better than having no lines of communication anywhere, di ba?
Yeah.
At least here, if you get a million letters, and we have gotten a million letters from the president, you actually have a chance to sift through it, find out what is the most pressing, find out what the pulse is, really what the need is, and then next, you prioritize, di ba? Mm-hmm. Yun naman ang trabaho ng government, prioritize the provision of service.
Yeah. So, dapat gamitin as tool for governance.
I think it's great. I think it's a great opportunity for them.
But, you know, leaders should really appreciate the value of social media. Just like me, that's my exercise. In the same way that we have multi-platform journalists, we should have multi-platform politicians.
Uh-huh.
Because it's a way to be transparent.
You're right.
And they owe it to the public.
Yeah. Gone are the days na nasa talk show lang sila. Gone are the days na press con, na nasa stage lang sila, nagsispeech. Ito, kakaiba na. Pero meron ding yung nagre-reply, pero medyo nakikipag-away, ano?
Yeah.
Ay, mas okay nga yun
eh.
Mas okay.
Mas okay yun.
Yeah, kasi nag-engage siya. Sa mga nanonood, mas okay yun.
Yeah. So, sino magaling mang-away sa gobyerno?
Si Bongbong Marcos, actually, mahusay siya makipag-away. Essay yung reply. Essay kung mag-reply si Senator Marcos eh. Pero yung mga one-liner replies yan, sila Senator Anasan, magaling sila dyan.
Okay.
And you can comeback my money.
You can distinguish between who's snooty and who's sweet.
For instance,
Abby
is a sweet girl. That's why I can't.
So who's the snooty?
Snooty but endearing. Mitas magsaysay.
My
favorite.
Sorry, we're gonna say something.
I think there's a big difference between national officials and local officials.
Yeah.
So national level, no problem. I think the exchange between people and government, as far as social media and the national level, is okay. And I think we're doing steps forward. Positive, very positive. But I think most of the citizens in the provinces would like to see more. Something like that.
Yeah.
Something like MMDA, something like local governments actually answering questions from the public. It's a tricky situation, totally different situation in the provinces.
We have to understand also when you're online, a politician on social media, you're really just addressing people who are online. So that's really just a specific population, right? Yeah. There's still a need to do the traditional venues. There's still a need to do the FaceTime to actually show up, which would be great. But I think social media can really support that. It's really not to replace any traditional media.
Yeah. It's a compliment.
I think we're all in agreement.
Compliment.
It's really not to replace the traditional media ways of communicating with the citizen. But this way, because for me, alam mo, ako, I'll reveal this na para fair game sa lahat ng tatakbo this 2013. If you actually reply decently to somebody who asks you on Twitter, you almost get 1/4 of a vote. Kasi grabe yung effect ng access of someone, an ordinary voter, and somebody actually replying to him. You say, oh, he listens to me. And all of us will have the arrogance to think na, nakikinig yan sa akin.
Replying
ganun. Kahit hindi, di ba? Yeah. Kahit alam natin hindi sila nakikinig in real life.
See, Goy Larizabal tweeted earlier, he was saying that, and we quote, social media is very helpful, and this is something you've been saying, and getting feedback, disseminating info, but do it correctly. So, di ba, merong mga, as far as you guys are concerned, ano yung mga dapat na standards for doing it correctly?
Tonyo, and I learned this from Tonyo, and I learned this from the group I worked with closely during Ondoy. You really verify, like, I had to, during Ondoy, we had to set guidelines, even via Twitter. May kapal na mukha ko, parang kunwari, in charge ako kaagad. I said, when you tweet us something, tell us the time you tweeted it and the area and who your source is. Kasi sobrang hirap na 7 hours later may bagong log on, i-retweet niya yung big baha na 7 hours ago pa nagyari. So we tried to set, even on our own lang, the people who were on Twitter during Ondoy. And then ako, I noticed myself just retweeting people I either know have worked with or have seen on Twitter for a long time. So it's really no different from real life credibility. Yeah. You must have had
Journalism standards.
Hindi
tayo dapat retweet lang ng retweet because we get into
yung
trouble
source,
that way.
In fact, feeling ko, pinakamahalaga sa Twitter, sa credibility, is really the source. Minsan nga, kung si Tonyo ang nag-tweet, kasi I trust Tonyo and even Holo because I've been with them online for a long time. Since Ondoy, parang
dalawang taon na yun.
Kahit na parang feeling ko, kahit mag-tweet siya ng link lang, ikiklik ko. Kasi I trust the source. As opposed to others, I will wait for a header or a title or a caption or something.
Tonyo, ano yung do it properly guideline mo?
The mindset should be all about service and accountability. So if you're a government official, don't go to social media if you think social media is just like a diario or a radio or napaka-one
way.
Or press.
You go to Twitter, if people tweet at you, ask you questions, do the XML.
And that would be a good gauge na rin, no, kung pwede kang tumakbo.
Can I ask a question? I want to know.
Wait, before that, teka.
Sorry.
Very quickly, ikaw, do you do it properly?
Because it's a chaotic world, you know. It's a chaotic
world. With a mask, by the way.
Yeah, it's scary. That's why I have a mask. Because they are fierce when they comment on my vlog. They're so fierce.
Really?
It's a chaotic world, so you have to be responsible.
Sana may every other week ibang muka. Parang si Cheese, ganun.
So what we do, is we try to be responsible as bloggers. As perhaps you as journalists and other responsible netizens, you create spaces where people can engage responsibly in a constructive discussion. For instance, like the TweetCon, and also on Move.ph, we hold discussions on Facebook. We just had our discussions with Ramon Magsaysay awardees. So you try to present models of good practices where people can engage, because people just bully now.
Instead
of bullying netizens, you bully the powers that be because they have the monopoly of the
maraming
use of
mga
power.
Fake accounts and harassment.
My question is, do you know and how do you feel about politicians who do not tweet themselves but then they do reply like it's them? Because I know a few di ba dapat sila yung nagtitweet?
Well, I take personal offense.
Ako hindi. Lalo na minsan may nagsispeech sa harap tapos bilang nagtitweet siya. Parang feeling ko,
I don't follow.
You don't follow
those.
Ayoko talaga pag hindi sila.
No, but sometimes they're tweet, like kunyari si TG. Alam ko minsan siya yung nagtitweet eh. Kasi there was a time na I tweeted something. He tweeted something, then I replied. Sumagot ka agad. And it was a, you could tell it's personal.
It was him,
But during the committee hearings, halimbawa, hindi naman siya. And sinasabi naman niya.
Senator Santiago is candid. She says, my staff will tweet for me while I'm doing the speech. Senator TG. So it's good. They have to they have to inform the public whether it's them tweeting or not.
Ah, okay. Nako, we ran out of time. I can't believe this. Wait, it's a social media edition.
Wala pa kaming ina-Alaska.
Bilis, Alaska nyo na ngayon.
In the US, for example, the White House Twitter account, even the Barack Obama Twitter account, many people use that account.
Yeah.
I mean, there are many people who run that account.
Mm-mm.
But there's a policy that if it's signed BO, it comes directly from the president.
Yeah, from Barack.
I think Filipinos deserve to have a social media guideline, a set of social media guidelines coming from government.
Yeah.
So we would know what's real.
Yeah.
We would get some accountability to the social media level.
Tonyo, before the show, an hour before the show, you tweeted, who are your fave government officials on Twitter? Who are your fave government agencies? Ano yung mga sagot sa'yo?
Well, MMDA is the runaway winner.
Ah, yeah. Okay.
And MMDA owes the public a favor, like teach government how to tweet.
Yes.
So if they're the gold standard, they should seize the initiative.
Sino favorite government official daw?
Well, there are many.
Many.
Senator Miriam Santiago, Senator Kiko Pangilinan.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think they choose those who tweet back.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Thank you very much. We ran out of time. Sayang,
I know,
di ba alam, part 2. Salamat, Tonyo, Gang, and Holo. Thank you very much for joining us. It's almost tempting to sign off with something you see on social media. Alam niyo yon, di ba? Yung yeah. K-Thanks Bye. K-T-N-X, B-Y-E ba or B-A-I? But we don't need to abbreviate that much on television. So we will go with Joins Again Next Tuesday. I'm your host, Beyonce Veras. Make sure it's nothing personal. It's Strictly Politics. Thank you. Good night.